Dr. Jennifer Pate. I'm Chief of Psychiatry at St. Luke's Episcopal Hospital. For the past 2 years, 2010 and 2011, I was awarded the top psychiatrist in America for my work on liver transplant and liver disease. And for the past 7 years, my practice, both inpatient and outpatient, has been almost exclusively taking care of patients with chronic liver disease. Psychiatric issues in hepatitis C are very complicated because most of the literature focuses on depression, but actually irritability, fatigue, insomnia, and substance abuse often complicate the treatment. I would recommend formal psychiatric assessment by an expert psychiatrist for anybody who has a current or past history of a psychiatric disorder. It's important to understand exactly what the diagnosis has been, what the patient's current and past treatment has been, also family history of psychiatric disorders, and both patient and family history of psychiatric hospitalizations and suicide attempts. So anybody with a known psychiatric diagnosis currently or in the past should be referred for evaluation before treatment. Depression screening tools can be helpful, but they miss some of the more complicated side effects of interferon and ribavirin treatment, including the hostility, more manic-related symptoms, irritability, agitation. So tools like the Beck Depression Inventory can be helpful for picking up depression, but they may miss mania. There are a variety of depression screening tools, and they may ask questions about your mood, your sleep, appetite, suicidal thoughts, thoughts about the future, hopelessness, your daily functioning, and those calculate to a mathematical score that some physicians use as a basis for referral to a psychiatrist. But I think we need to use referral to psychiatry much more broadly than that defined by a depression screening tool. So depression includes a wide variety of symptoms. First of all, it includes feeling sad or down for most of the period during several days over a 2 week period. You may have loss of interest in activities, decreased energy, difficulty concentrating, changes in your appetite, or potentially even suicidal thoughts. Anybody with suicidal thoughts should seek medical attention immediately. Minor versus major depression is more of an issue of degree of severity, including how much it interferes with your daily functioning. Typically, we think of major depressive disorder as a major psychiatric illness, but the good news is it responds very well to treatment. Anxiety includes feeling stressed, worried, tense, maybe even having panic attacks. And anxiety can also be worsened by hepatitis C treatment. It can also be worsened by putting a patient on an antidepressant. That's why formal psychiatric evaluation is very important. But the good news is that both medication and behavioral strategies can help with the management of anxiety. Bipolar disorder is a diagnosis that includes periods of hypomania or mania. And that includes symptoms such as distractibility, impulsivity. Maybe a person may feel like they have special powers. They may have so much energy that they don't need to sleep. They may have psychotic symptoms such as hearing voices. Their thoughts may race, their speech may be rapid, and this is clearly a change from their baseline functioning. Most patients with bipolar disorder spend more time depressed than manic. However, both depression and mania can be worsened by the hepatitis C treatment. There are many different neuropsychiatric side effects from the hepatitis C treatment. Usually these symptoms begin early on in the treatment within the first several months. They may range from variable moods such as tearfulness, feeling down, feeling anxious or stressed, to more significant problems such as insomnia, hostility, irritability, even psychotic symptoms. But most patients demonstrate fatigue, difficulty concentrating, and some difficulty with depressed mood or anxiety. but all of this can benefit from education, therapy, and potentially even medication. I have treated hundreds of patients with hepatitis C over the past few years, and I have not had anybody who has had to stop hepatitis C treatment. The important thing is that patients are thoroughly assessed prior to treatment, that their psychiatric symptoms are optimized, and they follow up closely with me during treatment. But I have never had anybody, fortunately, kill themselves or have to withdraw from therapy. Fatigue is one of the most common side effects of interferon-related therapy and often starts within the first several weeks. The important things to focus on in terms of managing fatigue are maintaining adequate hydration, eating a reasonable diet, working on sleep hygiene behaviors such as going to sleep and waking up at the same times each day, not going to sleep with the TV on, and exercising as you're able to do so. The fatigue often varies dramatically over the course of a week, depending on when the interferon injections are given. So there are a variety of interventions that are available for sleep disturbance. First of all, I thoroughly assess a patient's sleep behaviors, such as are they limiting caffeine later in the day? Are they going to bed with the TV on? Are they doing all the different kinds of strategies to help them relax at night and unwind? If medications are needed, there are several different medications that are safe in the context of hepatitis C treatment and in the context of even advanced liver disease. However, those need to be carefully prescribed by a physician knowledgeable about liver disease. The medications that I like best include Lunesta or low-dose trazodone, as these have both been very effective in the treatment of patients with liver disease with very few side effects. For patients whose fatigue does not respond to behavioral strategies, there are also medications that can be used for fatigue. Both medications such as Nuvigil or Provigil have been shown to be safe and effective, and also low-dose stimulants such as Ritalin or Vyvanse have been shown to be helpful. So hepatitis C is a disease that affects both the liver as well as the central nervous system. And also our treatments for hepatitis C, interferon, ribavirin, and the protease inhibitors also affect both the liver and the central nervous system. Most of the psychiatric side effects are thought to be attributed to interferon treatment. Because these medications affect neurotransmitters in the brain, it's understandable that there would be psychiatric symptoms and side effects associated with these treatments. Most of the time, if depression is going to occur, it will occur early on in the treatment and persist to some degree throughout the treatment. It's very important that patients are screened for depression and other mood-related symptoms prior to beginning the interferon treatment, as prophylactic treatment for patients with depression can often help patients successfully complete the treatment. If you have no psychiatric symptoms at all to begin treatment with, I would not recommend prophylactic treatment of potential side effects with an antidepressant. Also, it's extremely important that you tell your physician if you have a personal or family history of bipolar disorder or have symptoms consistent with bipolar disorder, as antidepressants can make this much, much worse. One of the very tricky aspects of hepatitis C treatment is the severity of the psychiatric side effects, including insomnia, problems with your mood, including sadness, anxiety, depression, irritability, hostility, poor concentration, range the whole gamut from minor annoyances to significant impairment in your family relationships and occupational functioning. One of the strategies I find most helpful is educating patients about the potential side effects. What makes this treatment extremely difficult is the side effects vary over the course of the treatment and are not consistent from week to week or day to day. But often educating a patient and their family about this variability is support enough and helps to minimize addition of other medications. I also recommend that for patients who are at risk of losing their jobs if they miss work frequently, if your company falls under the purview of the Family Medical Leave Act, I recommend that you have your physician complete this paperwork so that you have some legal protection in the event of absences during the treatment. Suicide is a rare but potential side effect of interferon treatment. Despite treating hundreds, if not thousands, of people who are on interferon treatment, I have never had a patient in my practice commit suicide on interferon and ribavirin treatment. The important risk factors for suicide include being a male who's older, who has limited psychosocial support with maybe a recent significant loss, such as loss of a job, loss of a marriage, death of a family member, loss of a pet, also a family history of suicide or a history of a patient's previous suicide attempts are the most important predictors for suicide. Please know that asking a loved one about whether they're having suicidal thoughts, whether they feel like life is not worth living anymore, whether they're feeling like they're hopeless or giving up will not cause a patient to kill themselves. It's important that as healthcare professionals, we ask patients on the interferon treatment each time we see them so that we can refer patients promptly who need additional support. Social support is very important during the treatment of hepatitis C. This is a treatment that is extremely difficult with many side effects, and you should not approach this alone. Reach out to family members so that they know what to look for in terms of mood-related issues and other side effects throughout the course of treatment. Also, if you're actively involved in a relapse prevention program such as AA, you may check with some of the fellow AA members, as patients with hepatitis C often find a subset of group members who are going through the treatment. It's important that you reach out and get social support. There are support groups through the Texas Liver Coalition, hcvadvocate.org, and there are both online and in-person support groups that can provide a valuable source of support during this difficult time. So treatment of psychiatric side effects in the context of hepatitis C treatment is extremely tricky. If you have pure depressive symptoms such as depressed mood, loss of interest, loss of energy, poor appetite, sleep disturbance, and antidepressants such as Lexapro or Celexa may be warranted. However, if you have a personal or family history of bipolar disorder, or you have symptoms of increased irritability or hostility or severe anxiety, antidepressants could potentially make the side effects worse, and you may need a different type of treatment. For anxiety, I like behavioral strategies such as the website called www.anxieties.com. Working on cognitive behavioral techniques for managing anxiety is extremely important, as many of our medicines for anxiety are potentially addictive or difficult to tolerate in the context of liver disease. For patients with bipolar disorder, I recommend that their mood is optimized prior to the starting of hepatitis C treatment, and various mood stabilizers can be used to treat manic or hypomanic symptoms such as irritability, impulsivity, or agitation.